So I need to do it just there, just bear with me just a second. I guess unplugging your webcam does that. Is that what's going on here? Why is that in that resolution? That's awkward, isn't Bear with me, well, I'll just do this. Process of lining things up again. I think that's probably about where he was. Actually, maybe a bit less. Kind of handy though, I've got the mostly speech-free thing up actually. Is that just about in it? I think that is just about in it. All right. I suppose I could have done that a bit more easily by just fixing the resolution of that, which I didn't realize was off actually. But anyway, we're back. We're sorted. We've got the layout of the streaming thing as we want it to be, and we'll continue with cinema, cinema's mobile style. So. Over the weekend, I actually did a bit of stuff and I figured out how to get the indices bar to actually occupy the full width while also enabling the sort of the progress people to also work correctly. So this is just hard setting the mobile version in the desktop. And also, I'll just like usual, I'll just pop this in the chat, just in case you fancy having a look. So, that's is that me? That is me. So this thing, you can see it now actually occupies the full width. And if you scroll through, get some longer indices. So this is a longer one. You can see that it's all working. And I guess what I'll do is I'll just turn off. Turn off the important colorization. So you can now see the actual style as it goes through. So this is all working correctly. And basically, the only bit of the puzzle that was missing was that there's multiple. I'll explain it fully. There's multiple things that this applies to. So this basically what we're talking about here. If I go to the mobile thing, suss out the width situation. This is what we're talking about, the width situation. We've got this selector here. This selector or this rule, whatever you want to call it. And this is targeting cinema content. So I was going through in Cineplay Post, Cineplay Pre actually. I was going in here in Apply Mobile Style. I was trying to set that for all of the cinema content. So I think I can get cinema content here. So you've got your Quizlet role now. I am actually selecting them all here, but I was doing it incorrectly at first. All I was doing was trying to select the first one, but I'll just show you what I mean. I'll just go to probably, I don't know. Maybe in the markers container. Not the markers. So let's just look at this one because it's the one that's current. This is a marker here, so this is the thing that's down here. Right, if you hover over, you can see that that is sort of going blue. Open this up, and you can see here there's a similar content. So this is the one thing. For each marker, I'm just selecting this similar content, and I was sizing that to the full width. But then I was finding that the as you progress through, it sort of throws off the actual progress bar, and as you hover over it, doesn't actually you didn't get the correct width. The reason for that was that they're within these guys, or the similar contents, which I've always been aware of, but I just completely slipped my mind. And you can sort of see that in here it contains the time code and the text. Same deal here, it's replicated down. And I'd simply forgotten, simply hadn't taken into account these additional similar contents. So that's why the sizing was the sizing was getting all thrown off, because they just weren't marrying up together. So yeah, that was it. So I remembered that. That was the main bit of the puzzle, remembering that there was the three for each thing. Okay. Another thing that I discovered, that I learned over the weekend, was that you can actually edit styles. You can actually edit like rules yourself, which is what all I wanted to do. So what I wanted to do, if you just go back to cinema.css, all I really wanted to be able to say was find this rule and set its value to be the width 320 pixels or the width whatever was available. That's all I wanted to do, and I couldn't figure out a way. But I discovered that it's possible, and the place I discovered that was, have I made a note of it? I don't think I have. I don't know. Oh, I might have made a note of it in the pre actually. Yeah, modify the CSS. So I discovered that something on Stack Overflow is this one on usefulangle.com. They explain how you do it. So basically, what this allows you to do is target the actual rule, the style sheet rule. And set that. It allows you to do that rather than actually querying for all the similar content and individually looping through them all, setting the width of them. That's what it allows you to do. So I think as a first thing that I need to do now, basically this is inside the function apply mobile style. And apply mobile style can happen under various circumstances. When you resize the player, resize the window, when you change the orientation, this thing happens. Now, the rule is always going to be in the same place. It's always going to be in the same style sheet, if it exists at all. So what I'm sort of thinking here is to just I've made a note of that, haven't I? Just do it globally. Just set that mobile cinema content with a rule globally. So that it's available for Apply Mobile Style to just use. It doesn't have to actually query it. It doesn't have to do any of this kind of searching business. Wherever it is. So let's see, this style sheet is between, so yeah, it's basically this. So it's a very short step, let's just do that. So we're in pre-on, which I suppose is fine. Get rule. going to take the style sheet file name. Well, actually, is that true? If you've got a if you've got a rule that's set in multiple style sheets, I wonder what happens actually. You got a rule that's set in multiple style sheets. Like, who gets precedence? I assume it would be let's try this actually, just before we go any further. Let's just discover something. Let's say that we've got a website. You've got three style sheets there, CSS and topics. Let's just add another. Well, we've got a touch test. Yeah, let's use this. So synonym.css up there and touch test down there. I don't think we've got touch test in the actual sync assets program. But that's no problem, we can kind of deal with that, I suppose. Let's say that if we've got in here this is the one that I've got. This is one of the ones that does actually show up. Yeah. Okay, so that's what it's set in here. And we go to touch test CSS. Background green. And we are seeing the touch test over. I'm assuming that this is the one that actually gets picked, so it'll go green. Interesting, it isn't. So let's just double check that do it the opposite way around. Actually, well, hang on. Actually, let's just first of all check that this can set it at all. No. Okay. Fine. Sent it to the wrong place, that's why. There we go, there's green. Now if we put magenta in, this style sheet is included before it. I'm assuming this remains green. Yeah. And now let's just see. We set this to be green and we set this guy to magenta. Well, it's still green. Interesting. Oh, sorry. Yeah, it goes magenta. So it sort of seems, doesn't it, that it's taking them in that order, but let's just try and confirm this a bit more. If we go into the site, we just take this and we put a touch test first. Regenerating it. So there's touch test going up there. Now what do we get? Now it goes green, yeah, so okay. So it seems that it's the second person, like the it goes through in that order. Alright, so all that's saying is that my function here, I'll just back these out. Excuse me. In search of this rule, I just need to work through the style sheets in the reverse order in which they occur. And as soon as I find the rule, I just return that rule, basically, is what that is. That's correct. Excuse me. All right, so let's just find the style sheet first of all. Oh, it's called selected text, isn't it? Let's pull it up. Just return the rule, but I sort of like I've adopted this kind of principle whereby you actually just only return at the end of a function. Oh, I lost our selector. Maybe let's just get that. I mean, I suppose it's a needed. I discovered yesterday that that's what that returns. It doesn't return an actual rule. It returns the index to the rule. Oh, bollocks, you don't have the style sheet. Yeah, that's true. So, I suppose you just plunk it in the first style sheet you've got, I guess. Yeah, I wonder if this is such thing. I'm gonna see if there's such thing as like a pseudo style sheet that you can just add it to. CSS rules. Yeah, let's just give us a function actually get style sheet. Oh, it's not the real code. Oh, interesting. The reason I thought I was thinking of doing it like this, by the way, was that I thought you need the real code part. To account for this. So yeah, solid. All you need is document style sheets 0. Oh, hold on. It's just the length. Let's just. Honestly. does say rule index. So on slash is zero, insert rule at the end. Okay, so get rules of style sheet. Oh, it's still not going to actually do everything we want, is it? Because all this is going to do. Fucking hell. Again. All we're doing here is picking the correct fucking rule code to account for this piece of shit here. Whatever, let's just continue doing it. Thank you. So this doesn't have to actually happen here. This rule here, get rule oscillator, we can define this straight out of the gate. Okay, so this is the bit where we actually are modifying it. Maybe I'll center content with rule, center content. I wonder what happens if there's no style sheets. That's what's sort of driving me out, like if you haven't got any style sheets. Well, I suppose we know, don't we? And I'm also going to sort of say, we don't bother with that actually. Okay, so whatever. We've got the actual Cinera, we've got Cinera content with rule, get rule oscillator. If it's undefined, then we insert a rule for our selector. Mobile center of content with rule selector. So that's worked, no problemo. That's all fine. We should be able to see also, initially the width that will have been set to something. Oh, did we stop printing it? Yeah, I think we did. No, we didn't. Oh, console log it. So the current value is this. Alright, so previously, I believe the current value would have been able to have been undefined, I think. Well, we can do that quite easily. Oh no, because it is inserted. So I suppose actually, sorry, what I'm talking about actually is not that. I'm suggesting, well, yeah, I was suggesting that the width should actually be set already. But they're reckoning it's not. Which is a bit of a surprise for me actually. So it found it, that's good. So the current value and the new value. But in finding that rule, let's just actually print out what it is. Sorry. Yeah, it's undefined. So they're suggesting find it. Oh, I think they're white, if we actually. There we go. No, it's not that. Here it is. Hold on, just a second. Let me just confirm something. If that's the selector we're looking for, then that should be found. So we should get rid of one. I think we should find it, and the property should be display in line and font size 14. I'm not exactly sure why the current value should be nothing though, here still. Right, there's the width and the height. They are set. Well, that's after they've all been resolved. That's exactly the same. So it doesn't suggest that it should find those things. Like display, for example, is set. Well, this should be set. Interesting. Well, screw it. I mean, oh, hold on. That's that whatever. Who cares? It worked. Double check if this works. Whatever, it works. Does the job. Let's do it. Okay, so that's going to set that out of the gate. That the pre person. The primary so I can just straight up go through it and set those values. Okay, so that was the doing that globally. What is the next thing to do? So a couple of immediate things are sizing this in sympathy with this. As this needs to take up more space, ensuring that the whole lot only remains within the height of the available area. There's that. There's also I need to sort out this coloration at some point. See that when I'm hovering over there, it's the wrong color. I need to sort out that. And there's also the positioning of the menus bar. I think that the sizing and sympathy will be the most in-depth thing. Let's go with the. I was sort of thinking of leaving the color just for the moment, but I mean, I suppose I could do that. Should be easy. It's just a case of modifying all of the theme CSS files. So I suppose let's go and do that. Actually, hang on. I don't need to do that. I can just still say. It's just this, isn't it? We just need to add this category medium here, I think. Faded, maybe. So this one. the kind of thing you can actually do, isn't it? Just in the thing. Now I think about it. There's that marker. I think it's actually going to be either faded on main, by the way, actually. So if we just go back up to here. Talking about there is the progress faded center of contact category medium. I mean, if I were to just stick that in here, oh, I think I know why. I think what's going on there is that it's getting mixed with the colour below it. So, yeah. Hover. All right, let's mix this color with this. So basically saying, yeah, I know how to do this. So we've got this initial caller of FF8 of this. Fill the foreground with your 42, 49, 14. Okay, so that wasn't it at all. But if I just, I don't think that's the right colour by the way, but if we just stick here, right now all of a sudden that's correct. I think if this is right, we just need to pick the right colour, basically. Okay, so yeah, we just need to pick the right colour. Isn't that unfortunate? Oh, hang on. Unless, maybe what's happening here, actually. Oh no, that's garbage. It's not going to be combining the same colour. Yeah, it's not going to be combining the dark blue with the dark blue that's underneath it. Okay, so he's just saying that it has no background colour. So that's how you do it, is it? These three things get the colour thing, but only these two are supposed to get the background colour. So that's all that was. So, right. It's the progress thing. Let me just also double check when we're actually going through here what happens. Fine. Yeah, that's perfect. So now we just need to do the same thing for everyone. So it's the progress in the content. Everybody gets the colour, but only these two get the background colour. Feel relatively confident that I could just go ahead without actually testing all of these individually. So that's always been working. That's the point. If you think about it, you don't need to set that color for the category medium. Well, maybe you do actually. If it doesn't get translated into a like an emoji type of thing, then you'll get. A category medium. Yeah, let's just do that actually. Let's in my settings. Oh, mind you, the pregnant one is going to show up as a. Oh, to my run. Let's just take this. Probably what's happening here actually, so it's just overwriting it with this. So I just threw those together. Color is coming through actually. When you're hovering, it goes to the color of that again. So yeah, I mean maybe that you just don't need to do anything special with the category medium. You know what? I'm gonna have lost this, aren't I? Oh, good job, I got it in somewhere else. I won't save it just yet. Ah, there you go. So this should be white, but it's been made black. Yeah. So I think that's just plain. I think that's just plain wrong. Oh, it's white. What I'm basically trying to drive at is here, just remove this from it. It's bitwise anyway. I don't know. I think basically, let me just see, first of all, if it put that thing back, just simply reading that, make it work. Think if it does, then we just delete that piece of information, I think. It does. So what it's saying here. Is apply that background color. And that color. Let's just go through and just delete it from the progress thing. For some reason, we thought that you might have needed it. Turns out you didn't. And so now here it doesn't even bother having it. At all. Well, it sort of has some of it, but it's missing the ref current thing, isn't it? This needs to be properly done again. I think we've done risky. Do it for sysadmin. In fact, you can sort of see there that these guys could be combined together. So that's that done. And the other things we were talking about was right, positioning the menu container. Now, basically what's happening here is as I get in positions, if I just use R to throw that up, they're getting positioned down here. The reason that is that the positioning relative to the menus bar itself. So this is the menus bar, and they're getting positioned at the bottom of the menus bar, which is insufficient. Really, what we need to be doing with all of the menus on the mobile stylus is to be positioning them relative to the player box, really. Suppose more specifically to the video box. But I don't think we can do anything. I think we need to reserve the video box for the video itself. I don't think we can put anything in the video box because that might throw a bit YouTube off. I sort of feel like what you do is you just take all the menus. And around you. No. What I was going to say was take all the menus, make them children of the player container, and position them relative to the player container. But now I'm sort of thinking, well, hold on a minute, why bother doing that? Can't we just say, position relative to the menus bar still. So if I just go to post and I just hard set this to portrait. Puts it this way around, you can see that these guys get positioned. You know, they're sitting below the thing. Which is fine, this is what us designed. We probably will want to set a max width for it. Oh, we need to sort out the filter size. When you're on narrower screens. Screens. So yeah, I mean, there's work to do on it. Well, let's say that we're in landscape. Let's put it the other way around. Landscape left. So the menu bar is going to be on the left-hand side, and still, obviously, the stuff appears below. By the way, I was bringing them up by using the hotkeys, which are like Q for the quotes, R for the references, F for the filter, C is the credits. And so we've got the quotes. Linking is Y also. What I'm thinking for this is could be quite complex actually. I'm thinking that we wanted to occupy this region here. And I'm additionally thinking that you do want to align it to this actually also. So basically what I'm basically driving at is say that we've got all this information here. Let's just say for the sake of your argument that this references menu is really long. Well, first of all, let's say that it's short. It's only one item in it. It's only one item in it, as I think there might be actually for this. Yeah, there's only one item, which is quite nice actually because it lets you design it. What I'm thinking of this, rather than like sticking that menu up at the top here, I'm saying to position it relative to the toggler, so it basically juts out just directly from the toggler. Right, same deal with all of these. And like as this grows to contain more things, it basically grows centered around this thing here. So you have like one item there. If you've got two items, they'd be like there and there. If you've got three, it'd be the middle one would be there, there and there. Right. So basically grows out from that kind of axis, I suppose. So what, I suppose the very, very first thing is just to see, can we position it relative to this? Not below, but on the right-hand side. Position. That's the first question. Okay, so this top value here was the height of the menus bar, which is kind of okay, isn't it? this was to do with setting the width, wasn't it? Yeah, sorry, of course. It's right there. Which we've determined we can do. So, yeah, I reckon we can get rid of this. I reckon we can just straight remove that. That is done and dusted. So we've got the title bar dim X. Okay, so now we need to sort of try and determine some things. So we know what the menu is. We can sort of just say here. We can say this. Offset height is the menu. I think we also know where the toggler is relative to the window, or rather the toggler relative to the menu relative to its parent, I think. I think we're taking the title bar DMX and the title bar DMY. Wouldn't it just be easy just to take the title bar itself? I think it would. Oh, and the video container, actually. Yeah, let's just make it do that. Oh, I think I know actually. This. Oh no. Yeah, it is. It is that. So saying the quote container is that. Think we need to know what the toggler is actually. Yeah, just get a parent element. Oh, hang on. Yeah, I think if I just. If I simply do that, does that let us get it? Yeah, I think it does, doesn't it? Yeah. So basically, I want to be able to get that value without actually displaying it. Fancy that. So what I want to know is what's the size of the content, as if it was being displayed. The size of hidden content as if it was displayed. Now, obviously, I can do it by just temporarily making it visible. We'd have to be a bit more careful about that, just making sure they've set it according to what it's actually set to. Interesting, I can't see it at all now. Oh, hold on. I think what you need to do is unset, actually, is what you want to do. Possibly. That was an error, wasn't it? Unset is much better. Don't know, actually. I'm a bit unsure about this. Yeah, because that's just going to pile them all up. So they're all sitting up at the top now. They're quite happy to sit up there. Simply setting it to block and then to none scrambles it up. This isn't what I actually want, but it's getting a bit closer. What I really want is to be able to say, what are the dimensions of this Yeah, I'm just saying, what are the dimensions of this thing, and push it up by half of that. Isn't it? That's all I'm trying to do, I think. Well, no, I want to push it down by the half the height of the toggler, and then push it back up by half of the height of the box itself. So does it still break if I, is it still broken if I just do the block thing again? Busted. So, we need a way to get that value. Really, the height that the menu would cons that the yeah that the menu would occupy if it was visible. But we've done about a couple of hours now, haven't we? Yeah, so I'm going to call it a day. Look how red the camera is, by the way. Don't think it used to be that kind of a colour. I feel like something's gone terribly wrong with this webcam. Color range as opposed to the default one. How's the frame rate looking? Says that the frame was like 8 frames per second, didn't it? Which seems quite low. Oh, hang on. Wipe out the temperature also. See if that makes any difference to the redness. It doesn't seem to be doing, but whatever. Who really cares? Doesn't really matter if this webcam is particularly accurate. So yeah, that's it for now. Thank you very much, Hayes and Hermes, for being here, for being beautiful and fantastic, and for being well coloured and well laid out. What was the original thing? The original thing was rules, wasn't it? Thanks for being rules based. We like rules based things. How about this? Evolutionary rules based things. So where the rules can evolve as they need to, in agreement with the people that are forming and living by the rules. So, size the indices box correctly, widthways, fix the size of that, split up that. Video content grows with the tangents area. A note, which is basically finish up sizing the menus containers. We just need to be able to determine So that's your lot. Until next time. Very fond. Farewell. Laters.